Hey guys, Clone Guy here, and today I have a replay for you featuring the Defender, aka the first tier 10 premium tank. Obviously that's not true, this is a tier 8 tank, but you know what, it kind of feels like a tier 10. Like, it is disgusting how strong the frontal armor on this tank is. It's the angle of the pike nose actually make this frontal plate more effective than the IS-7, and this is two tiers lower. And you get to fight sixes with this tank. Now, we find ourselves in a tier 10 game, however, but that is not going to slow this tank down. This tank is still going to just, like, kick some butt. It's an insane tank, and, I would have to say on the, higher scale of strength, probably, you know, around the overpowered mark, if not well past and beyond the overpowered mark, this tank just doesn't care what tier it gets in. Other than its view range, it is more than capable at any tier whatsoever. Tier 10, tier 9, tier 8, tier 7, poor tier 6s. Oh gosh, this tank doesn't care. It doesn't. It says hello to IS-7, and then goodbye to IS-7 as it face hugs the IS-7 in the IS-7 can't pen you. It can face hug just tanks. You're gonna see that demonstrated in this game. It's a disgusting vehicle. It really is. I got this during Black Friday sale. It came with this, the Umwa, and the Patriot, but I already had the Patriot, so I got a refund on the Patriot. And so I got this and the Umwa for, like, I don't know, 8,000 gold? It was something stupid. Like, this package, which came with the three of them, was like 12,000 gold, and then I got like 4,000 off because I already had the Patriot. So yeah, this is like 8,000 gold I got this and the Umwa for. It was an insanely good deal. Insanely good. So, yeah, anyway, we find ourselves on Westfield. Wait, weren't we just on this map? No, this is not Westfield, you're right. This is that other one. This is Panama. This is not quite Westfield, but, you know, it's close enough. Now, Panama has this open area, which I am in, on the to the left of the main brawl zone. And that's where we've decided to go, because I don't have much gun depression, so I've decided to go up here, and I think I can use it, because there's no artillery. So we're going to be using that fact here and make up a shot on this T-32. Hello, T-32. Derp. And there goes 395 of his hit points as he bounces off while I'm angling my pike nose. Because, you know, you're not supposed to angle your pike nose, but this tank just doesn't care. If you're top tier in this tank, go ahead and angle your pike nose. They're not going to pen you, guys. It's insane. This guy doesn't stand a chance, even with his... Oh my gosh, 465 damage roll. Even with his buff penetration of 218, he's still not going to do anything to this tank while... Like, really anything at all. There's a waffle to our left now. He's about to be clipping out all my friends. But we're going to shoot a shot underneath this guy, and boop, there we go. And now we're going to hide ourselves from him. He's just clipped two guys out, now he's shooting someone else. And he's still going. Nice, that's a waffle for you. Boring tank to play, to say the least. I hate that tank, it's so boring to play. I refuse to play it. But we're up to 1,300 damage and... Well, 1352, should I say, in just three shots. This thing has a 440 alpha on a 122, which is insane, because 122s usually don't start getting that alpha until tier 9, and you're on a tier 8. Okay, so you've got a tier 8 tank, you've got tier 8 penetration, you have tier 8 health, you have tier 8 view range, but you have pretty much a tier 10 hull, a tier 9 turret, and a tier 9 gun. Like, hello. Hello. Oh, and these shells, they don't travel slow. They travel over 1,000 meters per second on a 122. This is a laser beam when you compare it to other 122s. It shoots... Okay, so the FE-215B, the Tier 10 British heavy tank, you know, pinpoint accuracy on the move, its shells don't even travel this fast on that thing's 122. These things travel so fast. Boom, we sniped that guy. This tank isn't bad. In fact, the gun handling feels better than an IS-6, which is saying something, considering, you know, this tank is better than an IS-6 in every single regard, minus DPM. Other than that, this tank is better. This thing has more penetration on its standard rounds, and I think 265 on its premium. I'm not exactly sure what the standard is. I think it's 221, something like that, so it's pretty good. Anyway, we missed the shot on that T-100LT, we auto-locked, and he was standing right there, about 30 meters away from us, and who knows where the shell went, Russia, you know. But, you know, this time we're going to manually aim, and no problem, we finish him off there. Now we're going to go for the ram on this guy. Here we go, going down, and can we do it? Can we do it? Nope, he gets finished off by Action X, but there's an E-4 above us. He just fired, but I didn't notice that until now. Now that I just watched this again, he just fired, but I was trying to avoid his shot. Had I realized he just fired, I might have taken this differently. Anyway, We're going to try to get up to that guy. Because I had yet to ace this tank, and I think this was my first tier 10 game in this tank. This was one of my very first games in this tank, believe it or not, but I had a couple tier 8 and 9 games, and the games just went too fast. But then they give me this game, and I was like, alright, I get to test this thing's armor, let's do it. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm going to test this armor against this E4, and see if I can block some of his shots, which would be disgusting considering he's a tier 10 tank destroyer with nearly 300 millimeters of standard penetration. But there he is up there. Our Waffle just kills their IS-7. Now it's a 4-2. We should have this game in the bag right now, guys. There's four of us, and only two of them, one of them being a Waffle E100, and we have a Waffle on our team, so this should be a piece of cake. Well, this is World of Tanks, so... Yeah, it's not like there's three of my guys going up against one Waffle E100. Oh, E4 kills my Emil too. Okay, two of my guys going after one Waffle E100, right? It's not like that at all. So I'll try to 1v1 this guy. He just fired. Am I going to be able to get a shot off? Aiming at his cupola. Pop, straight into his cupola. We have our... Was that a premium round? No, it was not a premium round. Standard round goes straight through his cupola. That thing is not... This does not have the same kind of cupola as the E3 does. But now he's coming over the ridge. Are we going to be able to put another shell into us? He's going to put a shell into us for sure. And boom, we put it in. Is he going to put a shell into us? Come on, get close. Yes, he is. He's able to finagle the shot. I don't know if he hit my upper plate or my lower plate, but it doesn't matter. And the Waffle just killed our Waffle. Okay, well, hopefully we'll be able to get out of that. And our Death Star kills himself. And it's me versus two tanks. Put a shell into his side right there. Now we're going to get close. Come on, get close, get close. Here's the face hug. Come on, and... He bounces off of our turret. I think he might have hit our gun there because we stuck it up into his gun, and he's unable to break our gun because it's actually, when you hit someone's gun, it's a 33% chance of taking damage. But now we've got ourselves stuck. Come on, we're going to put this in. Yes, we are, right into the lower plate. And now we find ourselves in a 1v1 versus a Waffle E100. And this is scary. This is scary. And you're going to see the patience game. Patience game is going to come into play here. I'm going to be very, very patient. We know where he is. He's up there. So we're just going to sit here. We have 350 meters view range. There's no chance I'm going to outspot him. No chance at all. I need to wait for him to make the first play. I cannot make the first play. Unfortunately, that is just the case when you don't have good view range. You have to just, you know, let them make the mistake. Because as soon as I move, I'm dead. He's going to spot me. He's going to clip me. It's as simple as that. I do not have the view range. And that's that. The view range is so important. And that's what makes playing Tier 8 usually... pretty decent. I don't mind playing tier 8s and tier 10 games because usually you can max out your view range and at least compete with tier 10s and go up against and, you know, outspot tier 10s who refuse to use equipment. You can do that with your tier 8s. Not so much in the Soviet heavies though. The Soviet heavy tanks do not have any view range. Even if I put optics on this and I put food on this and I put vents on this and all that other stuff, I would only get my view range up to 444, which is actually still pretty good. Not gonna lie, you can get it to 444, but then I wouldn't have a gun rammer, I wouldn't have vertical stabilizer or enhanced gun laying drive, and all those other things that, you know, make the tank's gun work better. I wouldn't have a fire extinguisher, or in this case, two repair kits, you know. So instead, I have a gun rammer, vertical stabilizer, and I think enhanced gun laying drive. I think I have the same setup as my IS-6, so my reload is not the fastest, but I figured how often in a tank like this, are you shooting as soon as you're reloading? Probably not so often. You probably have to aim first. So I've decided to max out my aiming before I max out my reload. And so that's what I've done here. And yes, so anyway, we're still just waiting. This is what I've chosen to do. I refuse to lose this game. I want to win this game. I want to destroy this Waffle. And we're spotted, as you can see. He outspots us. But I'm not too worried. He should still be in front of us. If he starts shooting me in my side, if he's on my right up towards the bridge, I might be doomed. But there he is. Okay, we're good now. We're just gonna sit here like this. Ready? Come on, come on. Two, that's two shots. We're gonna try to blind fire him maybe. He's fired twice. Anything? Okay, so we need to remember that. He's fired twice. He's got four shots left, unless he goes for a reload. And I'm gonna wait till I drop off the radar here because I now have a plan. I'm figuring, okay, he might pull back and try to reload. Honestly, that might be his plan, is to reload and then come after me again. So I'm gonna wait to drop off radar. If I drop off radar, that is. Or just wait for him to get closer. Because he's probably got two things going through his mind. One, I'm going to drop back and reload. Or two, I need to get closer. Either way, I will have the advantage. If he drops back and I go undetected, I'm going in. If he pulls forward to get a better shot at me, I'm going to spot him. And I'm hauled down. Either way, I'm going to have the advantage. So I'm just sitting here. I'm no longer spotted. That tells me he's pulled back. So I'm going. Now's my chance. Nope, we're spotted now. He was actually pulling forward. Now the question is, did he reload a magazine? Probably not. We're going to fire the shot. Are we going to be able to hit? It's all the way. Yes, we are able to hit. We get the HE pen for only 522. We could roll that high with standard. But you know what? Let's not complain. He's pulled back. He doesn't have shots on us now. So now we're going to do it. We're going to do it now. We know where he is. We can get underneath his gun, and that's what we're going to do. You've got to know when to move up. And so that's what we're doing now. We are moving up. We're taking this game. I refuse to lose to a Waffly 100, and that's what we're going to do. You know, people think or say the Waffle E100 is overpowered. And in some cases it is. When it catches you off guard, catches you in your side, and it clips you out, that is pretty frustrating. Yes, it is. But, you know what though, they're easy to counter, and that's what we're doing here. We put another HE shell in another low roll, but you know what, now he's a one hit for us. He doesn't find a shot on us, because we were hiding our lower plate, and he decides not to shoot us. Now he's behind this rock, and all we have to do is wait, but I'm like, no, we're taking the game. We're taking the game. We're charging. We're closing the distance. That's what we're going to do here. He comes out to clip us out, but he bounces his first shell off of our side because we angled. Now he's coming around the corner again, and he bounces another one. He's down to two shots left. Now we're going to get in close. We can take a hit. Now he misses the last one. He's only got one shot left, and that's going to be it. And we finish him off, and down he goes. And we finish off the tier 10. We went 1 versus 2 in our defender, in our tier 10 premium tank. We went 1 versus 2 against 2 tier 10 tank destroyers, and we managed to win. We 1v1 both of them. And it was no problem, because this is the first ever Tier 10 Premium Tank ever introduced into World of Tanks. 180,000 credits made, 4,500 damage, not the highest scoring game, but I just wanted to show you just how broken OP this tank is, because it really is. Like, you can't argue that it isn't. This tank is disgusting. And then when you're fighting Tier 6s, it's even more disgusting. But there is the win. There is our ace tanker. Finally, we got it out of this tank. Finally, I say, and yet, like I said, this is one of my first games in the tank. Because it's just that disgusting. It's that broken. But anyway, I hope you guys all enjoyed. If you did, please slap that like button. Comment and subscribe. Make sure you go check out Space Bandit and GotADingy's YouTube. Links in the description below. And I will see you guys all later. Take care. And peace out.